That's what you get for kissing Courtney. How dare you?
Yeah, you like this, don't you?
Yeah.
Hello.
Hey, man.
What are you doing?
You still on the show this week? Leo was off there kissing Courtney. Can't believe it. I'm giving him a muck-up day prank that he will not remember.
Yeah, but that's my car.
What? Is it?
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Neighbourshood.
G'day, g'day.
Thank you very much for joining us, Felix.
Thank you for having us.
Sorry about your car.
It's all right.
On Friday, Yashvi threw the jury in, yes, into school and mucked everything up for Muck Up Day. Now, you're 19,
yes,
so you would have finished school not too long ago. Did you participate in Muck Up Day?
Yes, no. We weren't allowed, no.
You weren't allowed to?
No, no, the school hired
Times
security guards.
Times have changed.
Yeah.
They hired security guards.
They hired security guards. We were allowed one item of clothing.
Wait.
Out of uniform.
They forced you to only wear one item of clothing.
So I chose
this is a crazy school.
Yeah.
No, one extra piece of clothing.
One like non-uniform, and then we went and had a barbecue in the morning and then went home.
That sounds lame as. Mm-hmm. Have you heard of any other crazy muck-up day stories in real life?
There's the classic one of getting three animals.
Yes,
and landing
I love
them
this one.
One, two, and four. So everyone's looking for the third.
Everyone's looking for the third one. I only heard this like a week ago and I thought that's brilliant.
I think now I don't know if it was true or not because everyone has those muck up day stories that are like
the cow going up.
The cow going up the
cows
stairs.
Cows can't go downstairs.
Going,
now, for all of our British fans out there, do you guys have muck up day? Leave a comment down below. So essentially, muck up day is on the last day of school, kids back in the day, you should just do whatever they want.
Yeah.
Like egg people, break stuff, fill a pool up with concrete.
My mate took an alpaca to school, found an alpaca, bought one, and then took it to school, and then RSPCA took it off him. But I don't know if that's true or not, because there's so many stories, it just becomes just...
Oh! Yeah. It's that you don't know whether to believe it or not. Yeah. Just like this spoiler on Neighbours.
Oh!
Hey, guys. How are ya?
Hey.
What are you guys filming?
On that, how do you even get up here? It's
I ran past security.
Right now.
I ran past security. Who are you guys filming with? Who else is in the scene?
Just me and Mav.
Yeah.
I saw someone else on the...
No, you didn't.
Did you?
No. I think you're hallucinating.
You come on, guys.
Take a look
everyone at home would love to know, what are you guys filming?
All I can say is, remember the 6th of November.
What does that mean?
It means.
You gotta go, you gotta go.
What do you mean?
Remember
the 6th of November!
You gotta go now, you got.
It's up to you, Ben Riddle.
Hey guys, welcome back. Now we are ready for the low budget with available props blindfold game. Are you ready, Felix Mallard?
I am so ready.
Do you know what it is?
Nah.
Awesome. We've got a box full of props from Neighbours.
Yeah.
You have to try and guess from what famous Neighbours storyline of yours.
Of mine.
From. Okay.
Oh, it's a stethoscope. So that'd be...
It's a what? Say it again.
A stethoscope.
You said a... what did you say?
A
stethoscope. It's a stethoscope.
It's
and a stethoscope. And owned by...
And it's owned by Dr. Carl.
Very good.
This is my favourite tool when I use when I'm a mechanic.
Yes.
You can fix a car with one of these.
Yeah,
you don't
called?
Need anything else. I don't know, to be honest. This is a spanner, no, isn't it?
Yeah, I think it's a spanner.
This is a drill.
You basically killed someone.
No, I didn't.
Well, someone did. You were like running through the bush, and you were like, oh, Dad!
Oh, yeah!
Dad, what's going on? Granddad, what's going on?
Oh, this drill.
Yes.
When we drilled into old mate's head.
It's still got blood on it. I wish you could see it.
Yeah.
You got to stay very still now. Okay, it's not good. You're not going to be in any pain, but this is the only thing I'm going to give you, okay?
Dodgeball.
Yeah, that was so quick. Brilliant.
Oh, here we go. Durian.
Oh, yeah.
Where'd you get that?
We got it from the art department. Thank you, art department. Oh, God, it stinks. We're going to go to see who this week's cake taker is. Hello,
hey.
Jim Cano! How are you, mate?
Great.
You are this week's cake taker.
You've been a bit of an idiot this week, and the fans have kind of been going at you online.
Because you kissed Courtney, mate.
Yeah.
Yeah, what's that? What's that about? You're supposed to be with Mischi.
I know, but you got to do what you got to do.
Huge jerk face. People have got to say, for crying out loud, Leo, you idiot. someone else had to say, what the hell do women see in Leo? Now, I see a lot of good things in Tim Kano, but Leo just doesn't have the qualities, I don't think. You haven't been cake taker of the week yet?
No, I haven't. This is the first for me.
Usually when you get a cake taker, yep, weeks later, you're nominated for some kind of acting award.
Oh, wow.
It's fairly prestigious. Like, okay, yeah, you've had the cake taker.
Yeah, I went to Paris after I got cake taker.
What would Ben do if he could go back in time?
Oh, he would...
Maybe he wouldn't send that photo?
Yeah. He wouldn't send any nudies.
What was it called? A photo of me? Picture of me? What was it called?
It was. On the laptop, it was picture of me.
Picture of me.
Saved. So he's proud of it. It's not...
I've got a picture of me.
Ooh.
Hang on, no, I've got a... I'll zoom in. If you have been watching, guys, if you saw the trailer drop this week, you would know that Neighbours VS Time Travel is coming out next week, the Halloween special. Are you a part of it? Are you excited to be in there?
Yeah. Yeah,
yeah,
you're excited,
yeah,
I'm really
to be excited. In there? Yeah. Yeah. What does your character do for
nothing.
The time? What? What do you mean?
I'm not in it.
You're telling me that in this new time travel series, there's no Ben Kirk? How could that be? That must mean that Drew and Libby never met? Is that possible?
Could be.
Well, I guess our fans are just going to have to wait and watch Neighbours VS Time Travel to find out. We have got a little bit of a sneak peek at Neighbours VS Time Travel. A special guest, would you believe that Phil Martin is back for time travel, and we went and caught up with him on set. They're just shooting a scene over here. Everyone's dressed really strangely. Let's try and see what's going on. When you look at that, you just go, geez, I'm lucky.
No, I don't do the photo thing anymore, man.
Is that your rock star voice?
Just back away, man. I don't do the whole photo thing.
Well, what a rock star.
At least I write my own material.
Hey, you know, when I'm on tour, I try to read all the bestsellers, but couldn't find yours.
You know, I just knocked that hat right off of you.
Yeah, let's see you try.
Yeah. Just calm down, eh?
Yeah, security!
In this storyline, you're married to Susan.
I'm married to Susan.
I mean, we all saw it coming.
Yes.
I mean, the chemistry between the two of you was palpable.
It's always been very hard to...
Yeah.
Keep away from Susan.
There's nothing that's been more prevalent on the show in the last 15 years. It's just the lack of chemistry between Carl and Susan. Do you know what I mean? It's just...
Yeah.
But now that, you know, the two of you are here, it just... Yeah. This is great. I mean, the love is just extraordinary.
Extraordinary.
Oh, that's beautiful. You know, in the right light, you're an attractive guy.
Hey, in the wrong light, I'm an attractive guy.
If you're watching this back home in England, this is always how close the Neighbours tour bus gets to the action. Action is here.
I'm coming to see you, Martin.
Tour bus is here. They're always this close. They definitely haven't snuck through the gates and illegally come up onto the street. That definitely hasn't happened. It's good to see you guys.
Just an idiot. You are just, you do idiots so well. It's frightening how well you do idiots.
It's the only class I did at drama school.
Whoa, how's that for a spoiler? Yeah. Time travel!
Woo-hoo.
Phil Martin's back. I used to watch him when I was a kid.
Did you?
Yeah, I liked him and his family. Big week on Neighbours next week. Obviously, we've got the time travel, which is on every night, Monday to Friday. You guys can catch that online. And lots of things happening in the show next week. Mm. Looks like you're going to take the rap for Yashvi.
I don't know why I would do that.
Maybe you love her.
Maybe.
Gary's going to get unconscious. You know, you can get unconscious. He's going to fall unconscious. Stop being mean. You do the spoilers.
I will.
I know them.
Remember the 6th of November.
That's a big one.
Which is the ball, the big masquerade ball is going to come, and there's a lot of fireworks. And
so there's a big thing that happens at the end of next week. We can't actually give that away, but just you have to watch it. Well, guys, there's heaps on next week. Thank you for watching Neighbourshood. We'll see you next week. Felix Mallard, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
See you guys.
See you, bye.
Subscribe.